Hi, I'm Jan Rothenberg, and welcome to Good Karma Designs. I'm an interior designer, and I'm passionate about what I do. I believe that our best life starts at home, and I'm here to share with you advice and tips along the way how to make our home design dreams come true. So join us each week and find out how you can create your own inspired interior.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons, they fill you with fear. The trouble in my drag.
I'm Jan Rothenberg, and welcome to Good Karma Designs. I'm here today with my first guest, the amazing Max Tucci. And let me share with you a little bit about Max. I'm so thrilled to have him on today. Max is a celebrity chef for eHow.com, a lifestyle and interior design expert for About.com, in addition to hosting Radio Max and Friends on Sunday evenings for the last 6 years, and currently he's the host of Eye on the People with Max Tucci, which airs Sundays at 11 a.m. on WSFL, the CW. Max has written a book with Al Roker called Big Shoes. It's about fathers, and Max is a true believer in sharing the good karma. Welcome, Max.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Oh, it's my pleasure to have you and talk about good karma. Tell me, how did you come to all of this talent, cooking and design, and all of the variety of things that you do?
The spice of life.
The spices, yes. Share
well,
with us.
What happened was, I was born into a very amazing family. So my father and my grandfather owned Oscar's Delmonico's restaurant in New York, which Delmonico's, the Delmonico steak and the
right,
whole thing.
Right, right.
So
well
cooking
known.
And the kitchen were in my DNA.
Yes.
And I grew up in the kitchen of this famous restaurant that served 800 lunches a day and is famous for the Delmonico steak and lobster Newburgh and all these amazing dishes.
Yes.
And baked Alaska. I mean, the list goes on. And my grandfather created
it.
The wedge salad in the 1930s. So that was clearly going to be part of my my karma.
Yes, absolutely.
So to say. And then from there, you know, I grew up between Florence, Italy and New York. Mm. And when it came to the time to graduate high school, my mother goes, so where are you going to college? I said, I'm moving to Berlin. She's like, what? I said, I'm going to go to Berlin and I just want to experience life more than what I was already gifted to experience outside of family.
Right.
A walkabout. Right.
Right.
A walkabout. So I did, and I ended up traveling through Berlin and Italy and all these beautiful places. And then and really being exposed to such beauty in this world.
Culture.
So, and culture and architecture and everything that all these different areas in this world offer.
Right, right.
So when I came back to the States, I was also doing a fashion line at the time, a woman's collection, and it was taken off. I had red carpet, there were celebrities, it was like the whole thing. But it wasn't who I was.
Mm-hmm.
It was something I wanted to get involved in.
It wasn't
my
your
mom,
passion.
Right, it wasn't my passion.
Right, right.
It was part of the path.
Mm-hmm.
So, and my journey, but my mom was in the fashion industry, so again, that kind of all
right,
ties
right.
into the beauty of it. So then from fashion, I went into interior design. But not to the sense to study it, but more to offer what I've learned from my travels.
Right.
And bring in all these beautiful things from traveling.
The cultural aspects
the cultural,
of what you would learn.
Absolutely. And not only the culture, but to be bold.
Mm-hmm.
And just because we live in one area doesn't mean that we can't explore the world in our own home.
Right.
So, you know, we have now the stores like Home Goods and Fun Places,
right,
where you can journey to other countries.
Right, the world is
right. They, and exactly.
Yes.
So you have these opportunities to feel like you've traveled.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that was important for me for interior design, was to say, even maybe I can't leave my apartment, my home,
right,
whatever it is,
right,
but I could feel like I've lived this amazing life. So it's camouflaging your home.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
So to say.
With things that you love.
Yeah.
You know, as a designer, that's what I do. I listen to my clients and help them to surround themselves with things that have meaning to them,
right,
from their travels or places they'd like to go, mm-hmm, or styles that they love. Mm-hmm. And I really have to listen and intuit that for other people,
yeah,
and make that happen.
Listening is very important.
It's very important.
Especially when people don't know what they want in their home.
Exactly.
Because as I'm sure you've gotten, mm-hmm, a million responses, I want this. All of a sudden you're in China, you're in Morocco, you're in South Africa.
The world tour.
And it's like, but what do you want?
Mm-hmm. Right.
And instead, and then it goes into, well, what do you desire? And then it goes into, close your eyes, and if you could live anywhere at this moment, mm-hmm, where would it be? Because, you know, style changes.
It does.
So for me, it's living
changes.
In, where are you right now?
Mm-hmm.
Because last year you might have been in a different place.
Right.
Or you could have journeyed somewhere and wanted to redo your whole home because you went to Bahamas,
right,
or Jamaica.
You brought home artifacts.
Right.
And the beauty of changing artifacts, pictures, pillows, is that you can change the look,
right,
of your home. You can have a nice monochromatic base, mm-hmm, and change all those elements as you grow and develop through time.
Absolutely.
So that's a beautiful thing. Well, talk about, you know, I know you love Good Karma, and you talk about that a lot, and you live by that. Share with us how you came to that Good Karma, and what does that mean for you?
The journey.
The journey.
The path. Life path. You know, you were talking about my television show. I just had Grammy-nominated Sophie B. Hawkins on, and mm-hmm, I interviewed her at the Boca Resort.
Mm-hmm.
And we were talking about the life path.
Right.
And who's your teacher? And what was so fascinating was, we're our own teachers. Because if we're following someone, we're not on our own life path.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So that's something that I learned from her. But previous to Sophie coming on the show, I've been going to a place called Kashi Ashram, which is in Sebastian, Florida. And not for the aspect of, because I don't know who I am,
mm-hmm,
but because to have the moments of silence to reflect, mm-hmm, who we are,
right,
was important to me.
And meditation.
Right.
It's very
and also,
important.
What's beautiful about Kashi is that you have every religion there. It's not just for Hinduism, it's not for Buddhism or Christianity,
mm-hmm,
it's everything. Ma taught, who was the guru there, she taught, teach always, because all ways are his. So, and thoughts,
yes,
are just thoughts. So just to go to a place where you can be still and know. And, you know, I've had this incredible life and this incredible journey.
You have.
And it's almost bizarre to say the best is yet to come, because I feel like I've done so much. So for me, the whole karmic route is to just be still and know who we are,
mm-hmm,
or you are,
mm-hmm,
who I am, so that we can do our purpose,
mm-hmm,
and be our own teacher, so we could be on our life path.
Exactly. And they say the teacher shows up when the student is ready to hear
and
it.
We are the teacher. I think we're our own teachers.
We're the teacher and the student,
because,
absolutely, at the same time.
What's fascinating is no one will experience what you're experiencing.
Correct.
No one will experience what you're experiencing.
Right.
So it's important to say, we're our own teacher.
Right.
You know, when people say, oh, who's God? When we search for God, we find ourselves sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that, you know, again, the karmic of bad karma, good karma,
mm-hmm,
I don't even go there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I
judging,
just put out the vibration.
Right, right.
Because when we say negative, we automatically judge.
Mm-hmm.
When we say bad, we automatically judge,
mm-hmm,
to a lower vibration.
Mm-hmm.
So if we keep it all good and positive and love, you're not in that aspect to be able to judge.
Exactly. And when you put out the higher vibration,
mm-hmm,
that's exactly what you get back. What goes around comes around, and that becomes the karma.
Absolutely.
So it all goes full circle.
And I'm sure even when you design, you know, when you put your passion into it and your love for it,
yes,
it shows.
Absolutely. And when I join with like-minded people,
mm,
who don't have the wherewithal to execute what they want to create, I truly believe that when they're happy in their home, they're happy in their life. And the karma extends out from them.
Yeah.
Whatever it is they want to create, they'll tell me. And they want to create a retreat, vacation home, family home,
right,
more money in their home office. And we make that happen with these elements that you were discussing.
Yeah.
So share with us a little bit. You did a renovation recently. I think you said in South Beach.
I did.
Kitchen renovation.
Well,
love to hear about it.
About.com had approached me to say, would you like to be an interior expert? I said, absolutely. They said, do you have a great kitchen project? I said, I just did it. And it's being in the flow.
Right.
So when you're in the flow, that's when things come to you.
Yes.
And I said, well, we'll just use the apartment in South Beach. So it worked out. And then from doing that, I was able to redo the lobby of the building, which I've never done a commercial lobby. But literally, we took it from a nursing home feel to a mid-century, fun, hip Miami feel. South Beach.
That is very cool. And I know the kitchen I've seen on about.com. You can look it up. It is awesome. It's silvers and grays and stainless. And
tips, real quick tips, I think, for doing a kitchen is chrome is always a great tip.
Yes.
If you're clean. But it's not, you don't have to chrome your whole kitchen. Get mid-century percolators, mid-century blenders. Fun stuff.
Right, exactly.
And even if you want to have the kitchen that has the thick marbles and the heavy Tuscan look, you can still have fun with metallics and the
blending,
shine.
Right? Blending.
You get it.
Thank you so much. We're out of time.
It's my pleasure.
It has been amazing. Maybe you'll come back and visit us again
soon. I would
love
to.
Tell our viewers how they can reach you, Max.
Simple. Go to Twitter at Max Tucci or just email me, max@maxtucci.com.
Fantastic. Thank you so much
for being
here.
Thank you.
And please stay tuned for more Good Karma after the break. Hi, I'm Jan Rothenberg, and welcome back to Good Karma Designs. I'm here with Juliana, a wonderful, amazing yoga instructor. I am so happy to have on the set. And let me tell you a little bit about Juliana. She started her yoga journey in 1981 at the age of 17, practicing in South America, then moved to South Florida, where she introduced yoga to fitness and wellness centers in Broward County. In 1996, Juliana opened her first yoga studio in Coral Springs, and recently expanded to a larger studio called Yoga for Life. Her intuition, awareness, and connection to spirit creates the perfect atmosphere to help students find balance, strength, and inner peace. Welcome.
Thank you, Jan. Thank you for inviting me.
It is so wonderful having you, and I have been very fortunate to find Juliana and her yoga studio, and I go as much as I can. Please tell us, how did you get involved with yoga? At a young age, too.
Yes. I started at the age of 17 with the practice of it. Mm-hmm. My mother introduced me to it probably at the age of 14 with books.
Oh,
I started
so you read
with the Little
first.
Buddha, Jonathan Levin Siegel, The Little Prince.
Yes.
So she passed me those books before 17. And then at the age of 17, she brought me a phone number. I called, and that was my first teacher ever.
She was
a blessing in my life.
Yes. So first you learned, and then how did you become a teacher? What inspired you?
Mm-hmm. When I moved to the States, people made me a teacher.
They asked you?
They asked me, how do you keep in shape? And I said, I practice yoga. So they said, yogurt? I said, no.
Can we eat it?
No yogurt, yoga. So they said, can you teach me? And I said, sure, come to my apartment. I practice at 7 a.m. and you're welcome. So that's how I started.
Mm-hmm.
They made me a teacher. So I taught yoga for 10 years before I got certified to teach. And
wow.
I introduced it to
Amazing.
The fitness world before I was certified to teach.
Right, you introduced it to the health clubs,
the
LA fitnesses, all of those things.
Fitness Today, Planet Fitness,
Gold's
Gym.
Yes, yoga today is extremely mainstream. Everybody's talking about it and doing it. But explain to us how someone could create good karma in their lives via practicing yoga. How does that go hand in hand?
Well, when you practice yoga, what it does is it grounds you and it brings you into the present moment. When you are in the present moment, you clear the mind from all negativity.
Mm-hmm.
So when you're grounded in this moment and you're living with a high vibration, the karma that you're creating is very good karma.
Mm-hmm.
You're not dwelling in negativity.
Mm-hmm.
You're not dwelling in anger and frustration.
Right.
You're not carrying your past with you
because
you learned to leave it in the past and to pretty much just live in the now.
Yes, I've been in your classes, and they're wonderful, cleansing, centering experiences. I think one of the biggest things is that we race around, and the chatter in our mind is going, going, going. And often someone will sit in yoga class, and their shopping list is in their head. They're to do, they have to go to work. What do you tell them, tell people in your studio to presence themselves? Are there any little tips?
Well, the most important tip is to ground on the breath. The first thing that I say when they walk in, I invite them to lie down.
Right.
And to connect to the breath, to feel the body expand and receive the inhale, to feel the body release when they're exhaling. Mm-hmm. So it's a grounding feeling.
Right.
And I tell them, when the mind, when you get lost in thought.
Monkey mind,
yes. Come back to the breath and use it as an anchor.
Mm-hmm.
So the mind is not going to stop. It's going to go and go and go.
Exactly.
It is up to you to stop chasing after whichever thought comes in.
Right.
Just ground in this moment
and
let go
present.
Of everything else.
It's almost like a wave. Like, let the thoughts go out here and then ground back into the present.
Yes.
It's sort of an easy flow.
When you're living the now, it's very hard to get lost in the past or to become anxious about the future.
Right, right.
You're just very grounded.
And that's the only way we can really create is here in the present moment. We can't create
exactly.
back there, and we can't go to tomorrow.
No.
We have the best creation right here presently.
In the now. Yes.
And tell us about the fitness part of yoga. It's wonderful for the mind and the spirit.
Yes.
How is it for the body?
Well, the practice of the asanas, which means postures, is physically challenging, and it keeps you fit. You're using your own body weight to strengthen yourself.
Yes.
It's isometrics. You're co-contracting every muscle. You're using every muscle in your body. You do postures to cleanse the organs, to detox the body. You do postures to strengthen the body, to balance the body, which brings balance to everything else. So the postures are a gift, but I also want people to understand that the postures is not all.
Right.
And here, nowadays, is like yoga is like Cirque du Soleil. It's all about the pose. It's all about the pose. And people
right.
are forgetting about the breath.
It's not an athletic competition.
It's
you
not.
Encourage us to go at our own pace and our own level.
Absolutely.
And not compete with our neighbor. It's not gymnastics.
It's not gymnastics. It's not calisthenics.
Right.
It's an inward process.
Absolutely.
And that's the beauty when you teach it using the breath as the most important tool. Then the posture becomes secondary.
It flows
and
from there.
Absolutely.
Well, speaking of postures, can you please show us a few things our viewers can do at home to heal and strengthen the body and the mind?
Yes, I can.
Okay, great.
We inhale and open our arms. And exhale, bend the right knee into Warrior Two. And inhale, come back up. And exhale into triangle, reaching down to the leg, looking up or looking down. We inhale, come back up. And exhale back into warrior two. Inhale, come back up. Exhale, triangle. You can hold the pose here for a little bit to build more strength. And on the inhale, come back up. And exhale, bring it to the heart. Okay, we bring our feet together and face each other. Empty the lungs and inhale, take it overhead and look up. Exhale, take it to your toes and fold the body down. Inhale to your shins and look forward. And exhale, go back to the toes. Inhale, take it overhead and come up. Open your arms, reach up. And exhale to the heart. Namaste, Jen.
Namaste. Thank you.
Thank you.
Juliana, thank you for those wonderful yoga poses that we can all do at home. It has been amazing having you here today. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for inviting me. I enjoyed it very much. And I hope that everybody that can see this can get a lot out of it.
And how can our viewers find you?
they can go to iloveyoga.com. That opens up to my website, which is right now in the process of changing into Juliana's Art of Yoga.
And where are you located in Coral Springs?
I'm in 9739 West Sampo Road in Coral Springs.
And that's Yoga for Life.
And it's, they can also find me as Yoga for Life, yes.
Wonderful. And thank you for joining us here at Good Karma Designs. We're here every Tuesday evening at 7 p.m. And may the good karma be yours.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down.
Younger or thinking ahead of what it would be like to have a family, but having two girls, that can be a little tricky financially.
That's why we created American Express Serve, a full-service prepaid account that helps you handle your money simply and affordably. You can upload checks, pay bills online for free, and when you need to, you can always check your balance. With direct deposit, you get same-day access to your paycheck, and you can put money aside for when you need it. Plus, it's all backed by the 24/7 service of American Express, all for just $1 a month.
We won't think about the money in 10 years, but
exactly.
We'll remember that,
no.
That first middle school dance.
Get started today and let your Serve account help you take control of your money with ease.
I think we're doing a pretty good job.
This is what membership is. This is what membership does.
Get it at Serve.com or a CVS pharmacy.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine.
We do. Go you. Cigna. Tell us how being true to yourself keeps you healthy at Cigna.com/go you.
Come on, guys. Let's go. Why is this taking so long?
Come on. He's your grandpa.
Come on, guys.
Yeah. Yeah.
What was that for?
'Cause you're my grandpa.
Dollywood. Love every moment.
Thank you.
shuffling.
Fun and excite your kids about wildlife at the Palm Beach Zoo. Get close to hundreds of animals like endangered tigers, playful otters, even a Florida panther. The Palm Beach Zoo, it's your zoo.
Presenting Riverstone with the best of everything in an ideal Naples location. 11 gorgeous decorated models with a fabulous clubhouse and an incredible resort lifestyle included. You deserve the best. Luxury residences at Riverstone. From the 400s to the 700s. Immokalee East to Logan Boulevard. Visit glhomes.com now.
I believe that there are still mysteries in the world. And wonders. And surprises.
I believe that fun is a renewable resource.
That some things you'll never be able to download.
I believe that when we celebrate life,
in creatures big and small,
we discover connections
that stay with us forever.
Discover a place where worlds connect. SeaWorld.
Shopping, dining, entertaining, the Grand Canal shops at the Venetian.
Vandell, and you're watching WRPB ITV, and it rocks!
Wow, what was I thinking? This hurts. Oh no, girls. Keep it cool, eye contact. They see me. They see me. Ow, 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 ow.
What? You're getting a mommy tattoo.
Ow, ow, ow. Am I crying? I'm not crying. Am I crying?
Sweating on the inside? Handle it on the outside with new Speed Stick Power.
I love her so much.
Aww.
Speed Stick. Don't sweat it. Handle it.